How's it going, folks? We've got an action-packed JS Roundup episode for you today. So grab yourself a cup of coffee and settle in as I take you through all the recent news in the world of JavaScript. In this episode, we'll cover TypeScript 5.4, NX, React 19, Remix, and another Angular release. So let's go. TypeScript 5.4 has been published. With it come some new JavaScript features to play with. Object group by and map group by reach stage 4 of the TC39 process. Object group by and map group by take an iterable. You can also pass a function that returns a string that is used as grouping key, which returns either an object or a map. I flippin' love that feature, as grouping items from an array is a super useful feature, which is commonly used by state management libraries like Redux Toolkit and NGX Store. Accessing items in an array by its ID has a complexity of O of N, because you have to iterate through the entire array to find a certain element, whereas accessing an object by its ID in an object or map has a complexity of O of 1. This makes it way easier for us to write more performant code. Other than that, though, there's not a whole lot of super exciting features in this TypeScript release. There are some quality of life improvements, but they are somewhat niche and mostly relevant to library authors. You can find the link in the video description. Beginning of February, the NX team did an entire week of updates. I had to carve out some time in my calendar for it, but we invited Juri from the NX team to give us a summary. Hey Juri, thanks a lot for joining us today. How are you doing?
Hey, thanks for having me. Yeah, doing good.
Great, anytime. For our viewers that might not be familiar with NX, what would be your elevator pitch?
Yeah, so NX is a developer productivity tool, right? Focusing on monorepos, but potentially also like single project workspaces. And our tagline is smart monorepos, fast CI. So it kind of describes the whole end-to-end experience we are kind of aiming for and wanted to deliver to our users. And at a high level, basically, you can drop an X on any monorepo. It will run your tasks faster. We'll introduce caching and other kind of features to kind of make that faster. But then we also have those additional optional plugins that you can put on top to kind of even enrich that experience more. So usually those are very specific technology specific plugins. So for Angular, for React, Vue, Next, and so on. And they have things like code scaffolding mechanism built in to quickly build out a new app, integrate with Playwright, with Cypress, those types of things, which are usually can be kind of complex in a monorepo scenario. So yeah, that's kind of like the high level overview.
Cool, sounds awesome. So with version 18 of NX, you provided like a bunch of new features. Can you talk us through them one by one?
Yeah, so we had an entire launch week. I think the main theme were basically Project Crystal, which we launched. We had NX release, which is also a big one, really useful one. And lastly, we had NX agents, which is our CI counterpart, basically that enhances your CI runs and speeds up your CI runs. Those were the main three ones that we pushed out that week.
Very cool. So NX Crystal sounds pretty cool. Like, it's a great name. So what's the deal with it?
Yeah. First off, naming is super hard, but like, it's the worst. But Crystal, we came up with like Crystal at some point because it kind of conveys the idea you want to have with that new approach to how we structure plugins and how we apply plugins. And it is kind of the idea of being able to provide clarity and being able to see through something, right? So that's kind of the Crystal kind of theme. And the main idea behind is like our plugins are really useful. And a lot of people want to use it, but historically have been kind of more on the config heavy side of things, right? Mm-hmm. And so basically it was sometimes a stopper for many folks because they had an existing monorepo, but they wanted to go to the plugins, but it was more work. And so it's kind of like hard to also like kind of justify that, right? And so we had the idea of what if our Crystal plugins became more like ID integrations, right? Let's say you drop in an extension to an existing workspace and it just enhances your kind of overall experience with that. And so what we changed, for instance, is now our plugins directly read from the config files of the underlying framework. So let's say you have a React and Vite app, it will read from the Vite config. So things like the caching will automatically be configured based on the output gear you specify on the Vite config. It will read what input files you read from there. And so it's always in sync, right? And it at the same time removes that additional config file you might need to have in sync and keep updating and kind of removes that burden a bit. So that was one of the main kind of things that we wanted to push with it. Plus, it automatically is able to infer some of the targets you can run. So it automatically understands, hey, this is a Vite project. You can run Vite build, Vite dev, and so on, right? These types of things.
That sounds pretty cool. So you mentioned the NX release before. What's the deal with that?
So NX release, that's kind of like our approach to publishing packages, right? So you can have like a monorepo with different kind of packages in a monorepo, and you need to version them, you need to kind of provide change logs for them and so on. And so basically what we want to do with that NX release is to allow you to kind of have an easy way to kind of run through that versioning and packaging of these packages and publish them to say like to some NPM registry. And this is for monorepos, it's kind of tricky because there are tools out there, but they're usually not made for monorepos, but more like single packages basically. So the whole relationship between, hey, if you need publish package one, you need to also update package two and publish the second dependency first, then your main one. And so there's some kind of complexity behind it. But I feel like we kind of did a good job. And so on February, we kind of released to the public after dogfooding it on our own repo for quite a while. And so it's now ready.
That's awesome. And the last one you mentioned was NX Agents. What's up with that?
Yeah, NX Agents is like our commercial add-on for CI. So usually like having a monorepo locally, you need some tooling to kind of enhance it. That's fine. But like then when you hit CI, it can sometimes become a bottleneck if you don't do anything on that side as well. And so we want to kind of provide the full package, and NX Agents is kind of the answer for that. So what it allows is to kind of do seamless distribution of tasks across multiple machines. Because at some point you need to parallelize not just on one machine on CI, but on multiple machines. And so what NX Agents does is it automates that whole process. So on your end, basically, it's almost like a single liner on your config, on your CI config, that tells NX Cloud, hey, here are the tasks that NX gives you, distribute them on that many kind of machines, and then we'll kind of do the balancing out of distribution and parallelization. Always kind of keeping in mind all the dependencies that might exist between these projects.
That's pretty cool. All of those sound like they were quite a lot of changes happen, particularly under the hood. How does the update story look like for your users? What do they need to do to get to version 18, like the most seamless?
Yeah, so we, in general, with all our major releases, we have a specific NX migrate command. So that brings you always from one major to the next. So we write basically automate that migration script, kind of code mods almost, right? That bring update your config, update your code sometimes even, to bring you the most seamless way to the next version. Now for Project Crystal and NX 18 specifically, like it is actually a non-breaking major. We just meant like said like, hey, we should probably increment the major because the Project Crystal is such a big deal of what it can bring to NX like now onwards. And so that's why we dropped the major release in the middle of the year. While usually we just have like those May and October kind of releases with NX. So yeah.
That's pretty cool. And I know it's just been a couple of days since you did all those fantastic announcements, but can you give us like a quick peek of what's coming next?
Yeah, so there's the two sides of the thing. So there's the NX open source project where we kind of will definitely line out like some rough edges still on the Project Crystal project, and we'll keep improving that over the next couple of months. For us, Project Crystal is mostly an enabler for being better on the migration story, so in the whole incremental adoption story of the plugins. So with just NX, that already works, but if you want to go with the plugins, that was kind of harder. And so that kind of opens up like a whole new way of having a more easier onboarding from an existing reality, an existing monorepo into an NX plus plugins monorepo. And then there's the NX agent side of things, where we're going to enhance the whole kind of speeding up of the CI much more. There might even be some AI stuff in there in terms of like how we dynamically allocate new agents during a PR and basically in the end, like to speed up and help improve, like reduce the amount of resource you need to kind of boot up. That's kind of like the whole goal there. But yeah, exciting stuff coming up.
That sounds great. Thank you so much. Really appreciate you joining us for this. And thank you also to the entire NX team for this great tool. Really appreciate your work. Thank you.
Thanks.
We talked about React 19 on the last episode of JS Roundup, but the React team has since shared a blog post with some updates regarding the next version. React's compiler, aka React Forget, is already powering Instagram.com, which is a big milestone to reach and one step towards an open source release. The React compiler should help minimize the manual overhead of dealing with React re-rendering too often. If you were in a situation like this before, you'd usually have used tools like useMemo, useCallback, and Memo, which can clutter the code, require knowledge of React's rendering mechanism, and is generally breaking React's approach of UI as a simple function of state. The React compiler tries to automatically optimize those instances as long as you're working within some constraints. What those constraints are is currently unclear, but the React team recommends enabling strict mode and configuring the ESLint plugin to best prepare for the React compiler. If you care about SEO, you've probably already used React Helm before. React has now added support for rendering title, meta, and metadata link tags anywhere on your page, which is awesome when using, for instance, any router library. This way, you can easily give each of your pages a different title, and having that built in a library is really nice. Particular as it also works in any environment. It doesn't matter if it is an SPA, SSR, or server component. There's also much more coming in React 19, but those are the things that seem particularly interesting, at least to me. If I missed your favorite feature, let me know in the comments. Staying in the React ecosystem, Remix Vite is stable. Switching to Vite makes a hot module reload time 10 times faster and hot data revalidation 5 times faster. But it also grants access to the entire Vite plugin system. The benchmark was done during the beta phase of the Vite plugin on an M1 Mac, so there might be difference now with the stable version. Anyhow, make sure to check out the migration guide and start planning a migration soon, as V3 will deprecate the old compiler and only provide support for the Vite plugin. Recently, at a conference, I talked to Brooks, Remix Developer Relations Manager, and he explained the Remix team's vision for Remix to provide developers with an easy way to migrate from apps using Create React App to Remix. So I was not surprised reading about the new Remix SPA mode, but it is actually pretty cool as it allows you to build single page applications while still having some nice Remix features like file-based routing, route-based code splitting, and prefetching of route modules. Another month, another Angular release. Version 17.2 brings several nice improvements. We are another step closer to signal-based components. We have replacements for view and query children with a new signal-based query API. And now with model, we also have a signal-based two-way data binding approach. Though not always recommended, it is nice to have the option if it makes sense. There are also improvements to the Angular DevTools, making it easier to debug hydration mismatch issues. Additionally, there are also improvements to the ng-optimized image director, now having an additional attribute called placeholder, which will blur the image till it is fully ready. Angular 17.2 also supports Bunce Package Manager and allows for custom post-CSS configuration in the application builder. JSR, a new JavaScript registry from the Dino team. The open beta just started, but there are a couple of features they already announced. Support for all frameworks, runtimes, and bundlers, native TypeScript support, and it's going to support only ESM. It also comes with an automatic quality score for each package. Not sure how I feel about that, but in general, I'm very excited to see further announcements for this project and first real-world reports. A lot of us web developers started our career by hacking together some pretty terrible jQuery scripts. At least my career started this way. So I felt quite nostalgic to see that jQuery 4 beta was released, and reading that it dropped Internet Explorer support gave me some personal satisfaction. Fine, version 11 of Internet Explorer is still supported, but it's still progress. It does come with deprecation and breaking changes, but there will be a comprehensive migration guide. Vite 5.1 was also released with remarkable performance improvements, decreasing load times of 10,000 modules in close to 5 seconds. That's very impressive. It also comes with a new Vite runtime API, intended for framework and library authors. GitHub co-founder and former CEO Chris Vranstrath's GitHub account got suspended, making him consider moving to Bitbucket. Well played. That's all, folks. Thanks a lot for sticking around, and see you again next month when we'll share the latest information from the JavaScript community. Bye.